2012. Look how far we have reached. I mean, they say the world will end on 21st December this year. Let me ask you, what's basically wrong in having an end? What have we achieved so much that we should preserve these digital money banks or these metallic buildings? What do we really talk of at the cost of a sobbing planet or at the cost of those species' time? So let me tell you, even if you save this world, let me show you what it will be like in 2060. In a shocking incident, people claim to have met a real man who saw 40 years ago some real trees. Museums showcasing fossil fuels open to public today. Oxy-1, just as you have COPs these years, Oxy-1, a meeting of ministers of oxygen affairs conclude with the opinion that a Joseph Priestley could only help with this problem. Well, sounds funny, right? What if it really happens? You know what? Not everything is fine in this world that we are living in. Not everything is fine. This is the world that we talk of. The country that houses just 4% of the population pollutes 35%. Tell me, what sort of justice is this? We received a clean and a healthy planet from our ancestors, and we are gifting a damaged one to our successors. Well, what solutions do we have? What solutions do you have? And now I introduce you with the concept of climate justice and climate equality. Climate justice basically is a very wide concept. It's more about how we do things on a decision-making level. It can be summed up in three simple words: equal emission rights. On the other hand, climate equality is more about a community-based participation. Tell me something. We all claim our parental properties. We go to courts just to get the movable and immovable assets of our forefathers and fathers. Then don't we have the right to enjoy the same environment and the same climatic condition that prevailed during their times? This is what climate equality is all about. You know what? I don't like believing in climate change because I don't like to believe the worst. And it so happened that in 2050, I'll be 54. And I wonder what planet I would be seeing then. I wonder if I will be giving oxygen masks to the next generation. I wonder if my children would be able to play around the lake that I had played around. And more than that, I wonder if it ever will be a good afternoon to them. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the time for especially youth and children, the 3 billion of this world population, to show that we are concerned about this planet of 7 billion. We are concerned if a child cries in the remote villages of Africa. We are concerned if a species is denied existence. We need to connect the dots. Things cannot stay the way they are, and they simply have to be changed. And in this effort, we have a campaign named Plan for the Planet, which was basically started by United Nations. I'm very glad to inform you that United Nations has handed over this to us children and youth in the last COP in Johannesburg. Plan for the Planet, as you know, is a worldwide spread campaign that aims to plant trees mainly by contribution of youth and children. In this map, you can see the relative contribution of the nations in this campaign. And I'm very glad to tell you that India has been one of the top contributors for this. 2008 until now, it was launched. We have 100 academies across 137 countries in 4 continents. And now, we hope to involve until 2020, 1 million kids and youth across 200 countries. I'm very glad to inform you that we have already planted more than 2 billion trees all across the globe. And this is some of the efforts that we are making in India. For example, this, as you see, is a solar water heater, which is located at the headquarters in Patna. We have this have been particularly made by the students itself. This is how that particular headquarters work only on the solar electricity. And this one, as you can see, is a biogas collectors where the students all across the world come and learn more about waste management. And not only this, we have been also speaking all across India, taking out rallies, speaking across to the bureaucrats to make the change. And not just this, we have been also indulged in worldwide restoration of ecosystem at various places and raising issues at all international and national podiums. And also, I had a chance to interact with world leaders, and what I got to know from one of very top official of United Nations, as he said to me, as you grow up, you find more ways why things cannot be done. This is the ideology we need to reverse. As we grow up, we need to find ways things can be done. I just leave you here with two simple questions. If national security, peace, and economic growth are your priorities, then why not climate change? And are environmental problems really linked to any age groups or geographical boundaries? Well, my answer is certainly no. And last but not the least, we have made this three-point plan program, which was mailed to 200 world governments all across the globe, which asks that we children and youth call for putting carbon into the museums, putting poverty into the museums, and planting 1 trillion trees across the globe. That's like 153 per person. Just do it. Be a leader. If anyone who has solution to the problem is you. If the change has to become, it has to begin from you. Maybe Pythagoras would have been very helpless in this situation of this particular triangle, but I hope you all are not. If not here, then where? If not now, then when? If not us, then who? Definitely us. Thank you so much.